What? Luchini pouring from the sky.
Hey everybody, it's your girl Kenlo back at it again, and today we have a talented photographer. Let's get into it. Our girl Boujee Mustard.
Hey, what's up?
Hi, So let's get right into it. So I've been following you for a very long time.
Mm-hmm.
You can see,
for a grip.
Yeah. I want to know, how did you get started with photography, and where did you want to go from there, and how it just started the whole thing?
So I started. I started photography when I was like 13 or 14 years old. I grew up with, well, my parents are pastors. I grew up in a very like religious church background. But I started in church, and then I started doing events and like weddings and stuff. Just getting clients and stuff, and meeting people like at the church and stuff. Okay. Then I want to start doing portraits. So like I think it was about when I was about to go into college. I was just like, let me build up my stuff with portraits and stuff. And I started falling in love with it there, like fashion, and I just started bringing in all my inspirations together. Cause I would say music is one of my major like inspirations.
Like
that's one of the biggest things that helps me with my work. So to be able to bring in like music and like all these other like mediums and just bring it together, it just makes sense.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
So when you started figuring out your style, like how was that for you? Was it like hard? Was it easy for you to like get right into it?
Honestly, it was very hard, cause I always been in predominantly like white school. So okay. So trying to bring in things that I like wasn't really an option. Till I started, I was just like, you know what, this white folk won't tell me. Yes. So like and you know white people always call stuff urban. So I was just like, is that my style? And I'm just like, no, it's much more than that. So I started bringing in, mainly like 90s, 2000s stuff. Like I talk a lot about the No Limit covers. I talk a lot about Wu-Tang. Was it they on my wall over there? It was just trying to find where, like, how to make stuff, but how to make it align with, like, what I like, but also making it accessible to all people, to all the audience members and stuff.
Okay. So when it comes to photography specifically, are you that person, like, that finds inspiration for other photographers, or is it more music-based and more about, like, what you like as a person, like music, fashion.
It's all music based. Like I would say one of my favorite photographers of all time is Jonathan Mannion. He made all my favorite. He made the DMX cover, Flesh My Flesh, Blood My Blood, R.I.P.
The goat blood.
No, when he was in that where it was the all white joint, and he was coming out the tub, and it's like him like this.
Okay.
I always look at that. He's one of my favorites, and he made You know Joe, R&B singer.
He made
that joint. He just worked with so many different people, and that's kind of like what I want to do. I think like when I get a little older, I just want to make people's like album covers all the time.
I could see it. I could definitely see it.
That's what I want to do.
What is your favorite set to date? Like, what has been the best photo shoot that you've ever done so far?
Oh snap! Like overall,
or just I mean, we can do a couple.
Yeah,
we can talk about a couple.
Oh, that's a hard question. I think the way I can answer this is if I start by saying like who I like working with. I really love shooting with Ronnie Riggles, Eli 616. My friend Mark, Mark Anthony Addison on Instagram. Follow him. Painter. Amazing artist. Yeah. And Serena and Patrick. They're just, and not even because like I'm close with them, it's just I do feel like when you have a personal connection with somebody, it is easier to just go ahead and like photograph. But like when I shot with Eli for the first time, it was just like that. It was a quick. And then when I shot with Ronnie, he has a very like outgoing, very like charismatic personality. So like it was just easy to capture that like genuineness in a photo. So I think that's some of my favorite photo shoots.
What's up? Mm-hmm. So let's talk about the album that you recently came out with, Bouj. I loved it. How was that? Like, how was that process? How did you get creatives in Philly to come together? Like,
emphasis on creatives in Philly coming together. Yeah,
Philly come together, guys.
I think what really started that and what really like pushed me was it was just an idea, and I was just like,
okay.
I was like, okay, I saw Dreamville do it first. And I was like, I mean, not saying they were the first to do a collab right. album, but like, they did it well, they did pop, and they brought like everyone. And I was just like, if they can do it, I'm pretty sure someone in Philly could do it. Like, and I think one of the main important things was not being able, well, being okay with not everyone being involved. Mm-hmm. It was just because some people, even though you wish people could be mature and come mm-hmm. to a room together, some people just can't, and you want, they gonna have and to be okay. Okay. Right. And that, yeah, and that's okay, yeah, and yeah. that's a missed opportunity, but like, there's always for something else. Right. But I was able to pick a good group of people that were all like, had the same, like, I guess, like, I want to say, like, spirit and energy as I did, that just wanted to work.
Right.
So, like, that part was easy. And then it was just, like, it was 18 of us. Honestly, still don't know how I got.
That's enough.
Yeah, yeah, that's enough. Yeah, I honestly don't know how I can't even say just me, how all we all got these, like, artists together. Mm-hmm. But, it was just all about organization and making, keeping in contact. Communication is so important in large group projects. I cannot stress enough. Jesus. Yeah. But yeah, that was one of the main things.
And let's get into the recent project with the Cooligans. First of all, I love the colors. I love the art, everything. How did that come about? Like, where did that come from?
Okay, so after, I would say after the Boujee's Neighborhood drop, Ryan texted me. He was like, so I got this thing. This is my impression. I got this thing called the Cooligans. Like, you know what I'm saying? I got this thing called the Cooligans. It was him and Faye Lasso. It was their idea. They had talked because they've been cool, like beyond. So he was just like, you think, would you be down? And at first, I don't know. I was so tired and winded from the Bush Neighbor Project. I don't know if I can do no for a minute. But what was it? Ryan, he's just so. He's a huge dreamer. What is this? And so am I. So like, when you bring both these minds together, it was just like crazy. So I was just like, yeah, I'll help. And then next thing you know, it's January. We had the first session, and now here we are. It's May, and we got so much content rolling out this month and next month too.
Okay.
And and his album Cost of Living comes out next month. Very excited for that.
Stay
tuned. So it was just like, we already got these good group of people that want to work, and that were just very like, yeah, just passionate about our career. So we were just like, we might as well come together as one mm-hmm. and do something. And there, the Cooligans.
That's what's up. And there is a question that I love to ask every creative.
Yes.
What is your biggest advice to someone who's doing photography or just a creative in general who mm-hmm. wants to be on a level that they feel like they can't get to or want to get to?
I'll always say just stick to your style and don't let social media influence your art. Because I would say, I don't know for me, I was, when I was starting out, I would try to like, kind of like, not like copy, I'm just like, okay, this is the route to like, to get on top, right. And like in Philly. But I'm just like, no, this is not it. And then me and some other like photographers now, I'm just like, oh, I was following you. Oh, okay, nah, yeah, that's not it. So like, yeah, just keep to yourself, and you can build your own thing. Like, you don't have to go to all like these like certain events, like Philly Create, this, that, and the other. You can just right. build your own path, and you'll be just fine.
That's what's up. Yeah. I love to hear it. But you already know who it is, your girl Kenlo. You can follow me on Instagram at @thekenloshow_.
Yes.
And where can they follow you?
Follow me. I'm everywhere. Boujee Mustard. Just Boujee Mustard.
You already know the vibes. Stay tuned. We got more coming to you.
Introducing Phantom of the Dark. Walk through my heaven with levitation from Christian Chen, deep as any seven. Show boom.